Of course, looking at the world markets, over the weekend, there were talks that the trade talks between China and U.S. is likely hitting a brick wall. So the U.S. president says he's likely to throw in additional $200 billion in tariffs against Beijing. That is unsettling the global market as we speak. In case you've seen that on my tweet, yes, the Chinese stock market down 5% today. Yen is down. Australian also is down. And the futures on Wall Street looking negative as well. But how does it concern you? The price of crude oil is now heading south. Nigeria's benchmark, Brent crude, is now below $70 a barrel, $69.54, down $1.50 as we speak early today. Not looking like a good Monday so far. You need to brace up for what the rest of the week will look like. This is part of the story. But of course, the big story for Nigeria is the transfer of the M&A functions and business combinations from the Investment and Securities Act of the SEC to the new Federal Competition and Consumer Protection Commission, FCCPC. All of this will be part of what the market will be looking into. We have more conversations and discussions around that. But first, let's touch base with the market, where Temple Ashaju is standing by to give us a very brief rundown of how we finished off last week, the first few trading days of the new month of May. Temple, come in here and good morning. Bring us up to speed.
Good morning, boss. And so we lost 198 billion naira last week from the equity capitalization, as we saw the year-to-date performance worsening to 7.1%. And of course, if you look at the key benchmark indices, it was down to 29,212. Points basically, and that was that represents a margin of some 1.78%. We saw this whole lot of bearish sentiment across the market last week, and of course that was spurred by some huge profit taking across some bellwether names in the market, as you know. In terms of activity level, we were really positive last week. We saw some 21% rise in terms of volume of transactions week on week for last week, which was 1.47 billion units of shares that was traded in the four trading days that we had for last week, given the one-day public holiday that we had. But if you look at the top traded securities, we had Transcor, CCNN, Japol, Champs, Guarantee Trust Bank as the key companies that actually contributed massively to the volume of transactions. On the sectoral front, we got losses across three of the major sectors. And of course, we got some mild gains across two sectors. The banking segment was down 1.3%. Consumer goods on account of losses across PZ, Nestle, and Dangote Sugar was also down. Industrial goods segment of the market, we saw Dangote Cement losing some 369 basis points. And of course, First Aluminium PLC, which is about to be delisted from the market, also contributing to the losses that we had in that segment of the market. For the U.S., for the NASD O2C, you will take a look at that and you see a bit of bearish sentiment there. We saw 173.75 million units of shares traded last week. And of course, Riggs Ventures West Africa PLC led the week by volume and value of transactions, contributing some 172 million units of shares to the top traded, to the traded volume of securities on that side of the market last week. But if you look at the fixed income side of the market, of course, average fixed income yield closed flat at 13.65% last week. Numbers you have for bond side of things reflect some 20 deals yesterday on Friday, and of course, that's valued at 4.05 billion naira. For the treasury bill side of things, given the 109 billion naira worth of PMA that we saw from CBN last week, we saw that the T-bill side of the market was a bit of was kind of mixed. In general, for Friday, we saw just the 248 deals across the securities tradable and the treasury bill side of the
Temple.
Market.
Yes, Temple, thank you very much. Keep the rest of the bullets in your arsenal towards the end of the program. We have a lot more to check through. I know you'll talk a little bit more about how the market is reacting to the announcement on Friday by Forte Oil to sell off some of its subsidiaries. But first, the big story when we come back, a lot more insight from traders and analysts about the FCCPC SEC combination, joint advisory for the interim period, and of course the MTN planned listing. Let's take a break. We'll be back in two, everyone. Stand by.